Digimon Try was a disappointment. Now, I'm not too surprised by this, as my expectations weren't all that high, and shows like this are really hard to do right. When you try to add a sequel to fans who have grown up with a childhood show, it's will probably not go over all that well. So I'm not too surprised I found it to be lackluster at best and a complete train wreck at worst, though it does sadden me. So for day 6 of the 12 days of anime, that's what I want to talk about. What I felt went wrong and how it could have been something really great. And yes, spoilers ahead. So in order for a show like this to succeed, there are two things it needs to do right. First, it needs to appeal to nostalgia, recapture what made the original so special. And then the second is to go beyond that, tell an interesting story that can appeal to the now older and more mature audience. And for the first few movies, it was doing a pretty good job here. I really enjoyed seeing all the characters back, their interactions, and just the friendships. And especially the comedy made it feel like Digimon. And the story was pretty interesting, though a little bit messy, with it focusing on the lives of the characters and also the larger threat out there. And I especially liked when they really focused in on the characters, like they did in movie 2 with Mimi and Joe. Digimon is about how the characters grow over time as much as it is about the action, so that's the type of focus the movie really needed. We see a lot of shows out there that tell a story of how someone is called to be a hero, but we don't see that many about how life goes on afterwards. In this case, 6 years after Adventure 1 and 3 years after Adventure 2. So you can see them trying to live a normal life, which is disrupted again. Though sadly, after the first couple of movies, this sort of character focus was lost. And it instead felt like the characters were just strung along for the plot events that they needed to have happen. I also think the structure of the series hurt it quite a bit. Digimon Try was released as 6 movies as opposed to a traditional 26 episode series, and each movie felt like a normal episode from a plot perspective, just longer. So it was like they're trying to tell an entirely new story with 6 episodes. So that meant they could not spend the time fleshing out characters, even though they had time, if that makes any sense. And while typically movies are known for higher quality visuals, that was really not the case here, with the animation being mediocre. There may be one or two moments that really impressed me with how they looked, and then plenty of times where it was just cheap animation, shortcuts, still frames, all those good things. One example that really bothered me was the transformation sequences for the Digivolution. They were just way too long, uninteresting, and occurred too often. I know this is how Digimon works, but still, it felt like a lazy way to fill up time. They build up hype for a big fight, and then take a 2-minute break to show everyone transforming. What they should have done here is only do the long full versions when it actually matters for the narrative, and just like do a speed through it for the others like Kill la Kill does. But by far, my biggest issues with the show all tie into the narrative itself. Also, when I talk about it, I'll be using the English versions for the names of things because that's what I grew up with and what I've watched everything here except for the most recent movie. Alright, so one of the big issues is how they handle the events and characters from Adventure 2. Digimon Try wanted to pretend that Adventure 2 didn't exist, but was not willing to go all the way with it. Ignoring Adventure 2 would have been fine, that's like what Dragon Ball Super did with GT. But Try instead kept Adventure 2 as canon, but had the characters from it literally unconscious for the entire series. They also seemed to have the Digimon Emperor show up for a bit, and while that could have been an interesting twist with what could have led to that, they instead was just another villain in disguise for no reason. And it felt like this twist just betrayed the viewer's expectation. I wanted to know, like, why is Ken the Digimon Emperor again? Is he being manipulated? Is something else going on? But instead, none of that. It was just nothing. Not to mention how all the main characters seemed to just forget about the ones from Adventure 2 until Tai literally fell upon them during movie 6. Like, you would think they're friends. Things are going on with the Digimon. You want to reach out, find out what's going on with them. Are they okay? Can they help? All those things, but no. Not to mention all the other Digidestined across the world that were introduced in Season 2, just not there at all. They should have just retconned Adventure 2 away. That would have worked, because their focus was on the original characters, so let's not even worry about the others getting in the way. Another big issue I had related to how they handled the different power levels of the Digimon. There are different levels of them with there being a dramatic difference in power between each level. And the main Digimon can digivolve into more powerful forms, going up a level and doing so to fight. But in Try, it is often very unclear about what restrictions, if any, they have on being able to digivolve. So I wonder, like, why don't they always digivolve to the most powerful form to fight, and then hopefully finish the fight quickly? There was one time they kinda give an explanation in movie 6 saying that they can't go any farther, but there's no like real explanation of why, and that was the only time something like that happened. There's also times where the different levels between the Digimon fighting seems to be ignored for the sake of plot. For example, in movie 4, Gabumon attacks a Metal Seedramon, which is a rookie level attacking a Mega level, a factor of 1,000 difference between their two powers, so it seems really strange that Gabumon's attack would make Metal Seedramon dive underwater, instead of just being brushed off like nothing. And speaking of Mega level Digimon, I want to talk about the new Mega Forms. With Digimon, the new forms always seem to have some sort of weight to it, typically being related to a foe that they have no other way to defeat, and also a moment of character development for one of the characters. Though in Try, it felt like they were just thrown in because they wanted to. And while it was kind of cool to see them, these new forms just felt rather flat, and the Digimon didn't feel like they got a chance to shine in their new forms. There were also a ton of things that were just never explained or fleshed out, like what exactly Homeostasis or King Drazel were. We kind of get what they're after, but there's so much about them we never learn about. We never even see them. Or Kari's weird power, which showed up again here. And she seems to have a connection to homeostasis, but like, how does that work? And it felt like if they wanted to have this twist where Kari and then Gatomon became corrupted, they should spend more time with her, get into how she is feeling with everything going on, trying to remain hopeful, save everyone, versus her despair, especially when she thinks Tai was killed. Speaking of them pretending to kill Tai, but him really being fine just felt wrong. If they killed Tai, that would have been a major twist and an interesting one. But then it turned out he was fine. And it felt like a cheap ploy to make us think, oh, were they really going here? No, they weren't. I guess there's some interesting stuff going on with the other Digidestined, thinking that Tai was killed, but it still doesn't feel like enough. There are also other unanswered questions, like what happened to Maki after she made her way to the Dark Ocean? Or how Dark Genii got all the Digimon he was attacking the characters with? And then there's also the lack of the ending and lack of resolution, like yes, they solved some of the problems, but Genii is still able to do stuff. He already talks about his next plan. So what's going on there? Maybe that will be answered in the movie coming out in a couple years, but it feels like they should have wrapped it up more. You don't want to take a series that is complete, give it another iteration that then ends incomplete. So yeah, I think that covers my main points I want to make. I could talk more, but I don't think that would really add much to this. I just want to like get out my disappointment. Because Digimon Try could have been great. I was a huge fan of the original, and at the start it felt like they were doing what they needed to tell a new story in this world that would be really good. They were showing the challenges the characters had growing up, trying to be heroes in a world that doesn't have simple answers. There were moments that showed how the characters' strengths could be their weaknesses, and how they were having to face what they were fearing most. Or just the struggle of making some of the hard choices. Plus, I like seeing the bigger picture of the world, and Digimon Try was doing so many things right, and really well in some cases, but it was bogged too much by the just not able to execute on the ideas. So yeah, that's my sort of rant, review, whatever you want to call it, for Digimon Try. So, thank you for watching, and I will see you tomorrow with another video for the 12 Days of Anime.